greetings. Thank you, Khan, for your great question. Jesus answered him, "Truly, truly, I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God." Was Abraham a reborn? Was Elijah a reborn? Was David a reborn? As I said, that is a great question, brother. Thanks for asking it. Was Abraham a reborn? Was Elijah a reborn? Was David a reborn? The short and correct answer, I believe, is not when they died. The message of being born again was first clearly taught by Jesus Christ. And that is a subtle thing to understand, brother. Not every prophet of God came with the exact same message. Oh, they never contradicted the previous message. They expanded it and revealed new information. So Jesus brought the first revelation of being born again. And until Jesus was crucified and resurrected, men did not go to heaven when they died. Jesus taught of a place called Abraham's bosom. Luke 16:22. The poor man died and was carried by the angels to Abraham's bosom. The rich man also died and was buried, and in Hades, being in torment, he lifted up his eyes and saw Abraham far off and Lazarus in his bosom. Jesus also spoke of a place called Paradise when he was hanging crucified on the cross. Luke 23:43, and Jesus said unto him, "Verily I say unto thee, today shall you be with me in paradise." But we know this is not heaven where God dwells, because the same Bible asserts that Jesus would not ascend to heaven for 3 days. So it is likely Jesus referred to Abraham's bosom as paradise, the place for the righteous dead. The Bible records that Jesus went there and preached after his death. 1 Peter 3:18. For Christ also has once suffered for sins, the just for the unjust, that he might bring us to God, being put to death in the flesh, but quickened by the Spirit, by which also he went and preached unto the spirits in prison. Now that does not directly address whether Abraham, Elijah, and David were born again, and if so, when. But Jesus does make a revealing comment when he is describing prophet Yahya, or John. In Luke 7:28, "For I say unto you, among those that are born of women, there is not a greater prophet than John the Baptist. But he that is least in the kingdom of God is greater than John." Notice, brother, Jesus says, among those born of women. This is the experience Jesus referred to as born of water. And of those with only water birth, meaning not yet born again, of or by the Spirit, John is the greatest. So Jesus says that the least in the kingdom of God is greater than prophet Yahya. And Jesus had just said, there is no greater prophet than John the Baptist, or Yahya. This means that the least in the kingdom of God is greater than every prophet. And who is in this group, in the kingdom of God? Jesus answered and said unto him, "Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God." The born again. Those who have experienced the second birth. Jesus said only the born again could see the kingdom of heaven, meaning experience or enter or be part of. Because the opportunity to be born again only existed after Jesus was crucified and resurrected. Ephesians 4:8. Therefore it says, "When he ascended on high, he led captive a host of captives, and he gave gifts to men." Now this expression, "he ascended," what does it mean except that he also had descended into the lower parts of the earth? We have to analyze who these were who Jesus led out of captivity and led with him when Jesus ascended into heaven. it makes sense that it is the saints and righteous dead who had been waiting in Abraham's bosom. Jesus also taught that Abraham himself was looking forward to Jesus' day, or his time. John 8:56, "Your father Abraham rejoiced to see my day, and he saw it and was glad." I am confident at some point the righteous dead were given opportunity to accept Jesus as the Son of God. I think that obvious point in time was when Jesus preached to the spirits in captivity in Abraham's bosom. As great as Abraham was, he could not be counted as seeing the kingdom of God unless he became born again. But until the Messiah was cut off but not for himself, as Prophet Daniel says, people could not be reborn by the Holy Spirit of God. So, brother, no one was born again into the kingdom of God until after Jesus was crucified, buried, and then resurrected. And, brother, this singular fact is why Satan schemed to create a whole religion just to deny Jesus was crucified and resurrected. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.